Hey everyone, welcome to this month's episode. This month I'm going to talk to you a little bit about entering the market and a couple questions that clients have had to me lately about mortgage arrears and household debt. So kicking off, a lot of people have come to me and said, is now a good time to get into the market in the, over the next couple months, seeing as household debt is growing within Canada. There must be people who have made late payments on their mortgage who have to sell. So interestingly enough, Ontario has come from the lowest place where mortgage arrears have occurred in the country. We're actually looking at 1 in 1,000 people in the last couple months who have actually needed to defer payments. And most of these people are doing so only because they've been given the option. So that's not really the place where we are seeing a lot of people selling. In terms of where you can get into the market, really what we're seeing the best place is for you to actually go to the downtown condo area. Because immigration has been put on hold, especially short-term immigration where students are concerned, there are a ton of condos that have flooded the market. We've actually seen a 104% increase in listings that have come up for condos in the downtown area, which is one of the largest increases we have ever seen on record. This is because 58% of immigration is down. However, if you want to look at historical numbers, this time last year we had over 100,000 people coming into Canada on a yearly basis. So if you level them out, we are obviously at an all-time low for immigration, but this doesn't mean it's not going to come back. The biggest problem right now is short-term. So short-term, we do not have these immigrants coming for school, which is causing issues with the rental market. We also have people who are not wanting to live downtown because they're no longer going to work in the downtown core. And then lastly, for health reasons, people are not interested in living in high rises because social distancing can be a bit hard. If you're on the 50th floor and you have to take the elevator all the way up, you're likely going to see more than two people jump in the elevator with you. So reasons like that are causing a lot more inventory in the downtown market. This doesn't mean it's not a good buy long term, it just means that right now there is a dip. So if you are interested in looking at a condo, now is definitely the time. In terms of semi-detached and detached homes, we are actually seeing record lows for inventory for these two types of homes. This is just because, like I've been saying with condos, people don't want to be on top of each other, so they're trying to buy houses. And as they buy houses, there's obviously less inventory. Prices are going up as far as houses are concerned, which creates a little bit more of a gap between the condo market and the housing market. This is actually a good thing. What this means is that as the gap gets larger and larger, people are going to start buying condos again, which is going to close the gap. And then it's going to allow more people eventually to be able to leverage their condo in order to get a house down the line. So, bunch of things that I've just spewed out at you, most of them positive for the future, but in the short term, yes, you are going to see condos continue to go down in price and inventory levels continue to rise. That's it for today, and I hope you have a great day. Bye, guys.